Hello, and welcome to this presentation on making documents accessible. My name is Christine Adame, and I am Assistant Professor of Visual Arts at Texas Women's University. The aim of this video is to demonstrate how to use Adobe Acrobat Pro's Accessibility Checker to make your PDF documents accessible. To follow along with this process, you will need Adobe Acrobat Pro and a PDF document you wish to make accessible. This is what it looks like on your computer. If you don't have this software, you can request it using the TWU Technology Help Desk. I will also be working on a Mac system, so you may need to translate some of the steps and menu directions for a PC system. All right, let's get to it. Open your PDF document in the Adobe Acrobat Pro software. For some of you, it might be Mac opens PDFs in preview. If this is the case for you, you just need to right click and go open with Adobe Acrobat. Now, I want to pause for a moment and explain why you may need to make your document accessible. You may recognize my PDF as a document that was saved from Canvas. So while creating this project page in Canvas, I was careful to take the proper steps to make the page accessible already, including proper page headings, descriptive links, and URLs, or adding alt text to any images. So this means that a student who is using a screen reader will have a great experience in Canvas. However, if I wish to share this project outside of the Canvas system in a PDF format, the measures I took on Canvas do not translate to the PDF. So we have to recheck the accessibility in this program. This will allow for someone using a screen reader on the PDF to have a smoother experience. With the document open in Acrobat Pro, click on Tools in the top left and scroll down until you see Action Wizard. So you'll see a new toolbar opened here on the right. Click on the Make Accessible option. The toolbar will change to show your document name and list of actions that will happen next. Click on the Start button and we're going to follow the prompts. The first prompt is a description box. The most important area here is the title, which is basically the document title. It should not be the file name. So uncheck Leave As Is, and I'm going to type my title right here. All right. You can also add the author name by unchecking Leave As Is, and then click OK. The next prompt recognizes text in the document. This will allow for screen readers to pick up and read the text properly, and will also recognize images that may need alt text. So double check that the document language is correct. Ours is English. And then we need to change output from searchable image to editable text and images because we have a document with images. All right, I'm gonna hit okay. All right, so the program is now asking if there are any fillable fields for typing in information. I don't have any of those, so I will skip this step. All right, confirm or correct the reading language in the next prompt and click OK. The next box lets you know it is going to check for images that may need alt text. So we'll go ahead and click OK. The first image highlighted is the Edit button. Since this is only useful for Canvas, I'm going to click Decorative Figure so that the screen reader does not read that image. And I'm going to click on the right arrow. All right, now our map is highlighted here. This image accompanies the project directions and is important to the context. So I will fill in some alternative text. It should be fairly brief and very succinct. Map of Paris, France, because I have a caption after the image, so it's going to read all that information later. Save and close. All right, so now we have more accessibility checker options. All of these boxes are checked. We're going to leave them alone. So these are the rest of the checker actions that will be performed on the document. So we'll click on Start Checking. So you'll see a toolbar open on the left. This is the accessibility report, including things that pass and things that fail. I'm going to show you how to address these issues individually. So we'll go to the first set of issues for the document. All right, so you'll see the document passed the first three items, but it did not pass logical reading order. If you're ever unsure about what any of these mean, you can control click or right click and click on explain, and it'll pull up some Adobe information. For logical reading order though, I'll explain that. So reading order is basically like the order of how things are read by a screen reader. According to the accessibility checker, we need to make sure that the reading order is correct manually. For any of these manual check options, we need to dig a little deeper. So we're going to go back to Tools on the top bar. And this time we're going to click on Accessibility. It's this icon with a person. And it's going to open some more options here on the right. So we can start linking up what we need to fix on the left. So reading order, we'll click on reading order here at the bottom. So that pulls up a like different options for reading order. All right, so at the bottom, I want to click on Show Order Panel, and this is going to show like an outline that shows how the screen reader will read each item. From this outline and comparing to the page in the middle, you can see what the reading order is currently and make adjustments. I can see here that the first thing read is the title of the web page rather than the title of the document. So it's reading this like timestamp. And so that's not good. I don't want that to happen. I'll highlight the text in the outline here and I'm going to hit delete. And then that removes that first reading order item. I'm going to redo this so it just reads the title. So I'm going to draw a box around Project 5 Psychogeography Map. And then click on the reading order panel and tag this as heading 1. This is the most important part of the document. That looks good. So this is great. This is what we want. There are a few other issues here. I need to go down here and delete edit. Again, we don't want that read because it's not important to the content. Number 2 is objective. That looks good. Number 3 is the map of Paris, France. It'll read that alt text. And notice here I have kind of all this mess. It automatically found the text on the map, but I don't want it to read all of that. It's also registering as gobbledygook on the side. So I'm going to just delete all of these. Okay, so for our first page, this looks pretty good. The only thing I'll also change is you don't want the screen reader to read out a URL. That gets very long and convoluted, and it's not really necessary to the content. So I'm just going to delete that. All right, so page 1 looks great. Page 2, I'm not going to go through all of this, but it obviously needs some more attention. But for the purposes of time, I'm going to show you how to kind of manually check or pass this section. So I'm going to go over to reading order and hit close. And then I'm going to go back to my accessibility check, or I'm going to hit close here. So our little icon over here will pull up our accessibility checker. And so I'm going to right click and do pass. Now, it's not fully like addressed all of the things that need fixing, but I just wanted to show you how to do that. All right, so for color contrast, you'll look over the document and make sure that it is high contrast. To manually convert to high contrast, you'll go to Acrobat Pro, Preferences, and then you'll go to Accessibility and replace document colors. Use high contrast colors, and you can see that all of the approved high contrast color combinations. So we already have white text on black. So I'm just going to hit cancel and I'm going to right click and pass that criteria. So page content, this character encoding has to do something with the coding of the page like HTML. I don't quite know exactly what that means. I'd have to do a little more research, but for the purposes of this demonstration, it looks like what we have in our document checks out. If you check your document this way and have additional items to work on, remember you can always control click on the item in your accessibility checker and then click explain to get more information. Okay, so the last thing we want to do is save our work. So we'll go to file and save, and that'll save the accessibility options that we adjusted here in the document. This concludes my demonstration of Adobe Acrobat Pro and how you can use it to make your PDFs accessible. I wish you the best.